Hello everyone and welcome. In this video we will be discussing how to find out which mod is causing errors that eventually corrupt your save, and which mods cause errors that are most likely not going to corrupt your save, in case you really wanted to use the mod. So the first step is just to save you a lot of time and effort, and it may end up resolving the entire issue. Go to C. Then go to users folder. Then your username folder and copy the Zomboid folder to back it up somewhere else. And delete the original. I already backed it up, so I'm just going to delete this one. After that we launch the game in order to create a new Zomboid folder with a clean console.txt file. Then we copy the mods folder from the Zomboid folder we backed up earlier, and put it in the new Zomboid folder that we just created. Then relaunch the game. Now the game has registered the new mods. So we go to the new Zomboid folder, and we open the console.txt file to see which mods caused errors just while loading. We scroll down until we find log mod. And we check along the lines to see which mods were not found. Some mods will be showing the name clearly, while others are a little tricky and will be showing only the first two or three alphabets of the name. So some of these mods are better off disabled, since I personally had my share of trouble because of the mods appearing in the console as not found. But this is still not a guarantee that the mod is corrupted, so if you really like one of the mods that shows in the console is not found, then you'll need to go to step 2 to check if it's going to corrupt your save or not. Step 2 is going to the Zomboid folder that you backed up earlier and opening the console.txt file. This file should be having more clues as to which mod is causing errors, as it will be showing the log with the mods in use during gameplay. So again we scroll down and we stop at any line that starts with error. And we scroll down to see what caused it. We will either find the name of the mod, or an item that's included in the mod. For example here we find Slenderman suit, which will narrow down our search since I use 3 clothing mods. Another one here is the sharpen timed action, which narrows it down to only one mod that I use, that includes sharpening blades. Keep in mind that some mods may appear corrupt only due to other mods being active. Most of the times the mod developers will be mentioning if their mods are compatible with other mods. But assuming they don't, then you will have to go through the console a few times in order to know which mod is the actual reason behind the error. The first step saved me a lot of time and headache and showed some of the mods that broke the game entirely, which didn't appear in step 2, like the Le Gourmet Revolution which entirely broke farming. So again, the first step is more than enough to solve the issue. The second step is only if you really like a mod and just want to know if you can play the game despite it being a little buggy.